friends, today in our crash learning, we are going to learn about digit sum method. So what does mean by digit sum method? This method is very much helpful to find out whether our answer is correct or not. And especially for the competitive exams, this digit sum method will be very much useful. So in which way it is going to be useful, we will see it. So now, first let's know what is meant by the digit sum method. So I have taken a 4-digit number 5212. It is not necessary to take only 4-digit, any kind of digits you can take. Just I have taken an example of 4-digit number 5212. So what is the digit sum of this? Each digit, if you add it, what the value we are getting, that is called the digit sum. So each digit I have added, 5 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2. 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 1 is 8, 8 plus 2 is 10. So here 10, once again you add it, take all your answer to your single digit. What is 1 plus 0? The answer is 1. So this is what the digit sum of the number 5212. So how to do it even more easier? So why am I telling this method? Because to solve such kind of problem, so especially for the simplification, this digit sum method will be very much helpful. So now, so how to solve the digit sum very easily? That is called casting out the 9. What is casting out the 9? When you see the digit, when sum of any digits, if it is equal to 9, we can skip that number. Here, for example, you see 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 2 is 9. You just cancel it. What is the remaining number? 1. That 1 will be your answer. So in the same method, we'll use it. Once again, I'm repeating. If you feel that any sum of the digits is equal to 9, we can skip the digit. So for example, here 3 plus 6 is 9. Just cut it out. What is the remaining number? 4 plus 2, which is 6. 6 is what the digit sum of the 4-digit number 3264. In the same way, you just approach it. Here 8, 1. If you add, you will get 9. So the remaining number is 5 plus 2, which is 7. Take to the single digit number. 7 is the digit sum of this. 6, 3, 4, 2. You can see 6 and 3 is equal to 9. And 4 plus 2, which is equal to 6. And now what you can do, when you go for a trip, you can ask your child to see the previous, the vehicle number board. So the number board will be of 4-digit. So during the time of traveling time, you can ask the children to find the digit sum, so they will get the addition faster. So now this is the digit sum. So now let me tell you that how are we going to use it in our problems. See, we have taken a 3-digit number, and this is especially useful for the standard 6 and above, especially for the competitive exam. In a competitive exam, our ultimate aim is to find any one of this answer. So how to get it? Without actual addition, we can able to get it by using digit sum method. As I told, now each 3-digit number, you find the digit sum. So here, as I told, you see 345. If you skip 4, 5, the remaining is 3, plus here 6, 3. If you cut it out, the remaining is 7, plus 7 and 2. If you cut it out, the remaining is 1. These 3 are the digit sum of this 3-digit number. Now, once again added, what is 7 plus 3? 10, 10 plus 1, 11. Once again add this, take to the single digit number. Now, the entire value, the digit sum is 2. So how are we final our answer? So now the same way, each option you find the digit sum. So here 7 plus 2, 9. What is the digit sum? 3 plus 1 is 4. 4 is the digit sum, which is not matching with this. Now 9 you can cut it directly, and the remaining is 1 plus 1, 2. So here the 2 is matching with our answer. Now we'll see the remaining. 9 you can cut it out, 8 plus 1 you can cut it out, the remaining is 1. So again, which is not matching with our answer. Now here 7 plus 2 is 9, finally we have 5. So 5 again, which is not matched with our answer. So definitely our answer is 1199, which is the answer for this sum of the digits. Now this is the easiest way of the problem. Let's go with the simplification. So again, once again in the simplification, it is not only for the addition, but also for the multiplication, division, addition and subtraction, for everything. Now, let's say take this example and first let's find the digit sum of these numbers. So, the digit sum of this number 256 into 256 plus 173 into 173. Let's find 256 digit sum. As I told, added here, we cannot casting out any 9. So, 6 plus 5 is 11. 11 plus 2 is 13. So, once again, 13 you should add it. So, the digit sum 3 plus 1 is 4. So, 4 is the digit sum of this. So, 4 into here also you will get 4 plus, and here you check it, 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. Again, this 11, 1 plus 1 is 2, which is nothing but 2 into 2. As we all know, this is 4, 4 times 16 plus 2, 2 times 4. Once again, take to the digit sum. 16, the digit sum is 7, 7 plus 4. So, what is 7 plus 4, which is 11? Find the digit sum, which is 1 plus 1, 2. So, the entire value, the digit sum is 2. Now, we are going to find out 2 is going to match with which of the digit. So, that will be the option, that will be the correct option for this answer. So, now, just cut it, casting out the 9. 6 plus 3, what is the sum? 4 plus 2 is 6. Again, 6 is not matching with 2. This will not be the option. 9 you can cut it out. 5 plus 4 you can cut it out. 6 plus 4 is 10. Again, 10, you see 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 is the digit sum of this number. This will not be matched. Now, 9 cut it out. 5 plus 4 you cut it out. 6 plus 5, 11. In the 11, 1 plus 1 is 2. So, 2 is the digit sum which is matching with this. Then, 9 cut it out. 0 has no values. 5 plus 1 is 6, which is not matching with our answer. 9 you again cut it out. 6 plus 3 you can cut it out. The remaining is 4 plus 2. 6 again, that is not matching with answer. As you can see, that is the only unique value, that is option C, which is matching with our digit sum. See, it may take lot of time to solve this multiplication and then by adding. If you use digit sum method, so easily we'll get the answer only with the help of the digit sum of the problem and with the MCQ and with the options, you can easily get the answer. So option C is the correct answer for this question. Thank you.